Thank you for the introduction. So first of all, a little bit of introduction. What is high-order masking? As explained in previous talk, high-order masking is a widely used countermeasure to protect cryptographic implementation against side-channel attackers. It simply consists in splitting every sensitive variable into d random values, such that the sum of all these values are equal to the sensitive variable. It is a sound countermeasure since it has been formally proved that the more the masking order d grows, the more it is exponentially difficult for an attacker to recover any information about the sensitive variable. In the presence of masked variable, how to perform operations? Linear operations are linear in the masking order, whereas non-linear operations are quadratic in this masking order. Therefore, the main problematic when you want to protect a block cipher with higher order masking is to efficiently compute the non-linear part of those block ciphers, namely to efficiently compute the S-boxes. By efficiently, it means that you will try to find a representation of the S-box such that you have a minimal number of calls to non-linear operations. In 2003, at Crypto, Ishai, Sai, and Wagner proposed a secure scheme to perform secure field multiplication between two masked variables. So François-Xavier explained it a little bit. So when you want to perform the products between A times B, you will do it. You can see it as a matricial equation, and you can compute so first the cross product between the A and B, and add to it some random values such that the output will be the sum of these operations. This secure scheme is the main building block when you want to design S-boxes. In fact, in the state of the art, the main approach is to look at the S-box as a polynomial over a final field GF2 to the power n. And then you will try to find a representation to evaluate your S-box with those secure multiplications. The two main families of methods in the state of the art are first the family of generic methods where you try to evaluate any kind of S-boxes. For those families, the two best methods in terms of number of nonlinear operations are the CRV decomposition proposed by Coron, Roy, and Vivek at CHESS 2014, and the algebraic decomposition proposed at Crypto 2015. These both methods looked at the S-box as a sum of operations between family of polynomials, where for the CRV decomposition, it is secure field multiplication, and for the algebraic decomposition, it is composition of quadratic functions. The second family of methods will look at specific S-box and try to rely on the specific algebraic structure of the S-box. So for example, for the IIS, it is well known that you can see the S-box as the composition of an affine transformation and a power function x to the power 254. The best method will try to find a multiplication chain to evaluate this exponentiation with a minimal number of multiplications. So for this purpose, we have two methods proposed at CHESS, the Rivine proof and Kim Hong Lin. The difference between the two is that one is a bit longer in this chain, but works on a smaller field. In this talk, I will only focus on IIS, but in our paper, you can find also a work on present. So in this work, what we try to do is to propose optimized implementation of all these state-of-the-art techniques to be able to compare them together. To this purpose, we followed a bottom-up approach. First, we looked at how to perform base field multiplication in the most efficient way. Then, how to implement the non-linear operations, so such as the ISW multiplication or one of its variants, and then at the polynomial methods that I introduced in previous slide. All these implementations are done in ARM assembly and are optimized for each layer. In a second part, we tried to look at an alternative strategy for this problem, which is the bit slice method. So far, it has been used to design new block ciphers that are optimized for higher order masking. But here in this work, we show that we can also apply this strategy for already existing block ciphers and obtain speed records in, for higher order masking implementation. a little bit of background about ARM. It's a 32-bit architecture composed of 16 registers. You can manipulate 13 of them. And one of the most powerful tools that you're able to use with ARM is the barrel shifter that allows to perform shift and rotation virtually freely on one of the two operands. For example, we can see that this line that performs two operations, X time and an addition, this can be done with only one clock cycle due to this barrel shifter. Je peux avoir de l'eau. So now that we looked at the overview, let's jump into the subject. So first, how to perform field multiplication. So the goal of this section is to select an efficient implementation of multiplication over any final field GF to the power n for any parameter n. Intuitively, the faster way to do that is to fully tabulate the output of the operation. So you will need a table of size 2 to the power 2 times n. However, in the context of embedded system or smart card, you will have memory constraint, and therefore you cannot always use this. For example, if n is equal to 8, you will have a table of 64 kilobytes, which is too big for those kind of contexts. Therefore, we try to have an almost exhaustive look at all the way to perform field multiplication. So, for example, we started with the binary multiplication, which is the most basic way to do it. Then we looked at the xplug, which looks at the evaluation of an exponential of the logarithm of the sum of the two operands you try to manipulate. The advantage of this method is that the exponential and the logarithm can be tabulated with only table of size 2 to the power n. So this is way more efficient in terms of cost size than full table. For both this field multiplication, we have two versions. This is just depending on the fact that they need a modular reduction. And in the V1, the modular reduction is done by hand, whereas in the second version, we integrate this in the table, so we double the size, but it's still better since we gain some clock cycles. The third multiplication we look is the well-known Karatsuba, where you split both your operands in two, and then you will tabulate on smaller elements. You will need three tables. However, this multiplication, we can see that in any case, either in terms of clock cycle or code, this is less efficient. This is less efficient than xplug. In clock cycle and code size, and therefore we rejected this multiplication. But we tried to look at a compromise between Karatsuba and half table, which we called half table. So you split here only one element, and you will have smaller operation to perform the multiplication, but you will need a bigger table. So this is a trade-off between Karatsuba and full table. In terms of selection, for example, when n is equal to 4, we can see that the full table multiplication has still something affordable in terms of table, so it only needs 268 bytes, and it is by far the fastest way to perform the field multiplication. So in the rest of this talk, when we are working on a field where n is equal to 4, we will choose the full table, and when n is equal to 8, we will select two multiplications depending on our constraint. Either in terms of clock cycle, we will choose half table since it's faster, but it needs a table that is 10 times bigger than xplug. So now that we have a way to perform the field multiplication, that we extract the best algorithm depending on the size of the field, we can implement the nonlinear operation. So the first one we implemented is the ISW secure multiplication, which performs a secure field multiplication between two operands. In practice, when you compose several secure multiplications, you might need a refreshing for security reasons, but I will not go into detail about this operation, but it can be implemented very efficiently. The second nonlinear operation that we implement is an operation that allows to perform an evaluation of a quadratic function in one operand that is masked. in terms of implementation, it's very similar to ISW secure multiplication, but you will replace the field multiplication by just lookup tables, and this can lead to improvements since we saw that field multiplication can be expensive. The only downside is that this evaluation requires twice more random. So we implemented this method and we compared them, so between CPRR evaluation and secure multiplication, where the secure multiplication is looked for three cases, when the field multiplication is fully tabulated, when we use alphatable or xplug, and we can see that the CPRR evaluation is always faster than ISW as long as we can not fully tabulate the field multiplication. At this point, we were not fully satisfied since the way we use the register is not optimal. In fact, we have with ARM we have 32-bit register, but we only manipulated n-bit elements, where n is in practice between 4 or n 10. And the goal is to be able to perform several nonlinear operations in parallel. For example, when n is equal to 4, we want to be able to perform 8 elements and in parallel. And so on. And the consequence is that we can perform all the loads and the store and the XOR and the loops in parallel, but the only operation that we still need to do sequentially are the field multiplication or the local tables. In terms of performance gain, it is very efficient since we can see that when we perform 4 elements in parallel, we have against 4 elements in serial. For example, for CPRR, which is the best one, we have a gain of 44%. And when we increase the parallelization degree, we have even more performance gain since we are more than twice faster for ISW with the fully tabulated multiplication. Now that we have implementation of the nonlinear operation, let's look at how to the generic polynomial methods are done. So the basic idea is to look at the S-box as the sum of T operations between family of polynomials Qi and Pi. How to generate such evaluation? You will first generate the Qi at random from a basis B, and then you will find the Pi by solving a linear system. Then the main difference between the two best known methods, CRV and ALDI, is that the computation of the basis or the evaluation of the S-box for CRV is done with field multiplication, and for algebraic decomposition, it is done with composition of quadratic function. If you recall what I said about the difference between the speed difference between CRV and ISW, at this point we wanted to see if we cannot improve the CRV decomposition method by adding by changing the way to compute the basis in such a way that we can incorporate some CPRR evaluation in the case where this evaluation is more efficient than the secure field multiplication. In fact, for example, for the decomposition when n is equal to 8, in the original paper, the CRV used 5 field multiplication. In this work, we show that we can generate a basis with only CPRR instruction, and even more, we can increase the size of the basis in order to have smaller multiplication when you find the decomposition of the S-box that you have here. And therefore, at the end, for both those parameters, you have still 10 nonlinear operations, so 5 for the basis, 5 for the evaluation with original CRV, and 6 evaluation and 4 multiplication in this paper. But since CPRR in this case is more efficient, we will have some gain of performances. So we implement this and we try to compare them, and we can see that, in fact, when n is equal to 4, CRV is indeed more efficient since the nonlinear operation ISW is more efficient than CPRR, and when n is equal to 8, that the algebraic decomposition is the most efficient one. Now that we looked at the generic polynomial methods, we can focus on methods for IS, so polynomial method. As I said, it is the S-box can be seen as the composition of an affine transformation and a power function. The first note method was proposed by Rivain et Prouf at CHESS and looks at this multiplication chain with only 4 multiplication. due to a security flaw, it was one of the multiplication was replaced by a secure evaluation. And in 2014, Grosso et al. Proposed a new multiplication chain with three CPRR and one ISW. And this is an improvement since for IS n is equal to 8, and therefore CPRR evaluation are more efficient than secure multiplication. Another method proposed by Kim Hong Lin needs more multiplication, but on a smaller field. And what is the advantage of working on a smaller field is that you can fully tabulate the field multiplication, so you are more efficient. And the second best advantage is that you work on smaller elements, so you can increase the parallelization degree. And as we saw earlier, the more we can parallelize, the more we gain against sequential implementation. And in fact, the KHL method, even if it has more nonlinear operation, is more efficient than the revamp-proof method. So now that we looked at all the polynomial methods, let's focus now on the bit slice strategy. So in the bit slice strategy, you no longer look at the S-box as a polynomial, but as a Boolean circuit, where you try to replace every logical gate for software implementation by CPU instruction. And one advantage of using the bit slice strategy is that you can perform 16 S-boxes with only one call, since you will fill your register with all the elements. So for IAS, it's very efficient. How to apply this? You first need a circuit that is the most compact that is as much compact as possible. And the best known circuit is one proposed by Boyer and Hall, which is composed of 83 XOR gates and 32 AND gates. Then to translate it into a bit slice implementation, you will replace every XOR gates and AND gates by CPU instruction. And then to apply masking at order D, you will replace the XOR, since it's linear, by 83 times TXOR, and every AND gate by calls to ISWN, where ISWN is just ISW, where the multiplication is a bitwise AND, since we are on GF2. At this point, also, we don't make a full use of the register, so we want to improve this bit slice approach. In fact, for every nonlinear operation, we perform we want to be able to perform two ESW and on 60-bit register with only one call, where we pack the element in one register to have one 32-bit ISW and. So the goal is to reorder the circuit in such a way that every AND gates are grouped by pairs. We validated that we were able to do this reordering on BMP circuit. And the main advantage is that you can, at each run, you can compute the 16 S-boxes with 16 ISWN, so you reduce by 2 the multiplicative complexity, and then you will have only one nonlinear S-box per one nonlinear operation per S-boxes. In terms of implementation, first, let's compare the different ISW depending on the field multiplication. This is the same. Here we can see that the parallelization level degree is increased as much as possible, since we are working on bits, so we can do 32 elements in parallel, and therefore we have something that is very efficient compared to all the other ISW. And this result continues on the S-box evaluation, since we can see that the bit slice approach is by far more efficient than than the best polynomial method that are optimized. We also compared implementation of specific methods against generic methods to see how big the gap is, and we can see that relying on the specific structure of the S-box is very efficient, since generic methods are not that performant. In terms of timings, for a clock frequency of 16 MHz, we can see that we are able to perform an encryption with IIS in bit slice representation within milliseconds, which is a speed record compared to any other implementation so far. In terms of now, let's conclude. So in this work, we made a case study on ARM of different ways to solve the problem of higher order masking for S-boxes. We first selected the best field multiplications. Then we did some optimization for the nonlinear operations. We proposed new optimal parameters for the generic polynomial methods. We showed that KHL is indeed more efficient than RP since we are working on smaller elements and therefore we can increase the parallelization degree. And we pushed the parallelization of the implementation to the optimal by using the bit slice strategy that allows us to have new speed records. And one key question could be, could we use this bit slice strategy for any S-boxes, so for generic methods? And this is something that we did in a work that was published earlier at CES 2016, where we propose a generic decomposition method for S-boxes in the bit slice representation, which can be seen as optimizing multiplicative complexity of Boolean circuits. Thank you for your attention.